Hello, my dear students. Hi, this is Dr. Sheetal Randhir. Today we are going to see the basic concepts of business ethics. Business ethics, it is very important topic, which is for BBA, MBA and BCom also. And in general practice, it plays very important role. Now, let us understand the basic concept of ethics. The word ethics is derived from the word ethos, which means character. It is also known as the moral philosophy, which is a branch of philosophy that involves systemizing, defending and recommending concept of right and wrong conducts. Ethics involves understanding the difference between right and wrong thinking, action and using principled decision making to choose action that do not hurt the others. It means this is the choice between wrong and right. Next. So here is one chart which will give you the entire scenario. See, first, ethics, that is obligatory, must. We must do this, we must not do that. Then prohibited, we must not. Then omissible, it may not. And permitted, it may. So you can see the contraries, implications, subcontraries, implications and contradictories in this chart. So again, I will say, what is ethics? This is the choice between wrong and right. Next. So let us understand this concept through the very famous philosopher Aristotle. What he says, according to Aristotle, ethics means how to lead the good life is one of the central questions of the ethics. Again, this definition focused on the good life, don'ts and do's. Next. So let us understand this example. Like, there is a train, people are standing across the track. So we don't know whether this train is going from this side or that side. So what is prohibited? We should not, in this, we must not, until the train will go, we must stand, we must watch, we should not, we must not across. So that is the ethics and ethos. Now the next, so let's see the definition. According to Philip Will Wright, he says, ethics is a branch of philosophy which is the systematic study of selective of the standards of right and wrong, and by which it may ultimately be directed. So this is the direction for the human life. Next. So let us understand the small concepts which is the part of ethics. See, many times we have a confusion. Ethics means values, ethics means morality, ethics means ethos. Yes, but everything has their different meaning. Like ethics, this is concerned with the organization, in same profession, constraints, business laws, religious content, connotations, seeks to reserve questions of human morality by defining concepts. So ethics, that is a set of standards which we have to follow in the organization level, in the group level. Now the next is values. It is an individual concept, different motivation through process, parents sense of what is wrong and what is right. As being a human, we always have this sense whether to go here or there, this is wrong or this is right. So that is depend upon our beliefs and our values. So values, it is an individual thing. Then morality. Morality, it is very important concept in the management. Morality, that is a personal thing. Personal, religious, connections and customs, which we have to follow personally, but for the group, but for the standard of beliefs. Then next is ethos. What is ethos? Ethics word is derived from the word ethos, but the meaning of the ethos is guiding belief that influence behaviors, emotions, or even morals. That your set of standard, your set of standard of your own beliefs, which has been creating from your childhood, that guides you every time, personally, individually, or in the group. So that is your ethos. So if you'll ask me, all these are together, are these a part of one structure? So yes, ethics, values, morality, and ethos. Yes, now the next. So that's why ethics, it is a very important part. Now, according to Swami Vivekananda, what is mean of ethics? Ethics is the morals, the laws, the values, the equality, fairness, principles, and code of conducts. So, as I told you before, like this is the part of whole structure, and that is the ethics. Okay, now the next. Okay, now let us understand our topic, and that is business ethics, code of conducts in the business which we have to follow. According to John Donaldson, in 1989, he focused on the following definition. He says, business ethics, in short, we can say it can be described as systematic study of moral, ethical matters pertaining to business, industry, or related activities, institutions, or practices and beliefs. My dear student, if you'll see this definition, you will understand this definition focused on the ethical matters related to business, industries, then work activities, and the institution practices and beliefs, which is a part of your business, which we have to follow compulsory, rigorously. Now the next. According to next definition of Stanford Encyclopedia of the Philosophy, which is written on the 2008, business ethics, or you can say the corporate ethics, it is a form of applied ethics or professional ethics that examines the ethical principles and moral or ethical problem that arise in the business environment. It implies to all aspects of the business conduct and is revealed relevant to the conduct of individual and entire organization. Again, this definition focused on the form of applied ethics. Whatever we are believing, whatever is our set code of conducts, whatever our values or ethos, other than that, this definition focused on the applied ethics, which we have to use as a code of conduct in the business. So that is the business ethics. Now let us understand this definition in this diagram, with the help of this diagram. Again, business ethics, that is the moral and principles which we have to follow in the business. Business ethics, that is, we can say, the legal things, legal responsibilities, economic responsibility, ethical responsibility, which we have to follow while doing our business activities. Then moral and standards, as being a worker, as being an employee, as being a shareholder, as being a stakeholders of the business, we have to follow some morals. We'll have to follow some set of code of conducts, set of beliefs. So that is a part of business ethics. Then ethical practices, yes, while doing the selling and the marketing activities or production activities, we have to follow some ethics. We have to follow some rule, sometime which is must, sometime which is should, or sometime which is compulsory or expecting. So the next is the ethical codes and principles. Ethical codes and principle, which is like a norms, which is given to every industries, sometime according to law, sometime according to regulations. So that is your business ethics. And the rules and regulations, every business have their rules and regulations, so which we have to follow, that is also part of your business ethics. And yes, the last is innovation. While doing the innovation about your product, about your business, about your marketing strategies, about your advertising. It should not be harmful to your customer or your stakeholders. That is the business ethics. Now, hope you understood the entire concept of the business ethics, and this diagram or this chart, this photo will clear the picture about the business ethics. See, what is business ethics? First, the principles of the business. Then the very important reliability. Then trust. Then responsibility. Then choice. Then below, behavior, relationship and morality. My dear students, the below diagram is very much important. These are your ethos, which will definitely give the success and sustainable development and growth to your business if this is strong. And above this diagram, then this will help. The choice is yours: responsibility, trust, reliability and the principles. So hope you understood the basic concept of business ethics. Now let us understand the very important, and that is 3 C's of business ethics. In the business ethics, 3 C's are very much important, which we have to follow. The first is compliance. The need for compliance of rules, including laws, principle of morality, policy of the company. My dear student, laws, yes, we have to follow. Principle of morality, yes, we have to. And policy of the company, we must. So this is a very much important C of the in the ethics, that is compliance. Now the next C is contribution. Business can make to the society. Business has to give certain contribution to the society, like the core value, the quality product and services, the employment, the usefulness activities to the surrounding activities, and the quality of work life, which is very much important. My dear student, here again I want to make you remind one chart of the economics, and that is what that the shortcut was the Uma Kina Guru. That is when the production increases, demand increases, then prices increases, then investment increases, employment increases, again we can say income increases, and again the employment increases, again the investment increases, and again the production increases, demand increases. This chart is very much important in the business. While doing these business activities, business has to give the certain contribution for the welfare of the society, with the core values, with the quality productions, with increasing employment and the useful activities around the business area, and the quality of work life. And the next 3 C's, the third C's, and which is very much important, that is the consequences of business activity. Like, it includes towards the environment inside and outside the organization. Our activities, our business activities must not be harmful to the environment inside and outside of the organization. Then social responsibility towards the shareholders, bankers, customers and employees of the organization. And the last is good public image, which is also known as a goodwill, sound activities and the good image of the organizations and employees and the stakeholders. So these are very much important C's in the business ethics, which every business has to follow. Now the important concept, and that is scope of the business ethics. So as being a student, you may have this question. We know the do's and don'ts in the business, we know the laws, we know the regulations, then why we are learning business ethics? Do we really need to learn this subject? So the answer is yes. According to Thomas Donaldson, ethics in the business, a new look has observed that there are some key reasons why business ethics is vital and why ethics plays a key role in the business. he has thrown the light on the scope of business ethics. In short, I will say that Thomas Donaldson has given the scope to the business ethics subject, and that is scope of the business ethics. There must be the positive consequences of the business, the goodwill of the business and the businessman. So in short, we can say the image of the business, then protection of the both side, business and customer. Then self-satisfaction, which is very much important, not inside the organization, outside the organization also. Then encourage the others, including your competitors. Then success and development of the business. And the last is new management. Every business must play the ideal role in front of the other business, in front of the market. So hope you understand the basic scenario or the basic concept of the business. So my dear students, with this slide I'll conclude the session. Once again, thank you very much for your time. Thank you.